Hey guys, it's Erica, and thank you so much for joining me here in my kitchen today. Let me start off this video by saying, if you hear this occasional little click in the background, that is a cardinal that is obsessed with pecking my windows. So the cardinal goes all along this side of the house. You're probably gonna hear it all day in this video. Please ignore it. But today I wanted to actually take the time to do a video that so many of you have requested over the years, and I don't know why I've not done it yet, and that is how I do my cookies. So y'all know I love to cook, I love to bake, but deep down my favorite thing to do is make cookies. I guess I'm a bona fide cookier, okay? That is what they call folks who specialize in cookies. So I love it. You know, I've been doing it for a few years now. I'm self-taught. What I want you to take away from this video, okay? In every area of life, really, you know, if you compare yourself to others, you are setting yourself up for disappointment, okay? There's always gonna be somebody prettier, younger, smarter, more successful, whatever it is, okay? But what sets you apart from others in every area of life is your mind, your heart, your creativity, and your hands, okay? Those are things that no one else can take from you. Those are things that are specific to you. So there are things you're gonna be able to create that I can't, you know, and vice versa. So what I want you to feel after watching this, I want you to feel empowered, and I want you to know these cookies are not as hard as they look. Like the first time I ever made my cookies, I just watched a few videos and I thought, you know, I'm the creative type. I'm the DIY type for sure. And I just thought, you know what, let's just try it. And I was blown away. So what I want you to know is you can do this. You can make cookies for your family, your friends, your loved ones, that they are gonna be amazed that you made, okay? So a few things you need to keep in mind, recipes. It's really not about the actual cookie recipe. Definitely the icing. The icing that I use is royal icing. I'm going to get into all the specifics with that. I will put my just a basic gingerbread cookie recipe down below, and then a basic sugar cookie recipe down below. Myself, I mean, you can do just a basic sugar cookie, okay? But I really do think you're going to have a really better tasting cookie if you add some almond emulsion in there. So like an almond extract, it tends to bake out during the baking process, but an almond emulsion, it's gonna retain that almond flavor, and it's just gonna give your cookies a little something extra. So they're extra yummy, extra delicious, and not only do we want a beautiful cookie, we want a yummy cookie, right? So in terms of a sugar cookie, it's my recommendation that you either add a little bit of almond or a little bit of lemon extract, lemon zest, just to give your cookies that extra little, you know? With my cookies, I do everything from scratch. So my cookie dough is from scratch, my icing is from scratch, and then I have all of the decorating to do. So in years past, I have done all of that in one day before, from making my dough, and then once you actually get your dough made, you're gonna wanna let it sit in the refrigerator for at least 2 to 4 hours before you roll it, cut it, bake it, and decorate it. So what I have found is I've made it very stressful on myself in the past. If you can kind of plan ahead and you know you're going to be making cookies for an event or for a holiday, something like that, then you can definitely make your dough ahead of time, and then you can actually give yourself some time to prep, you know, to roll out your dough and cut it, and then bake your cookies and let them cool before, you know, just jumping into the decorating process. So that's what I've done. I actually prepared my cookie dough yesterday, last night, and I did film that for you. It's very straightforward. Anytime you make cookie dough, basically what that is going to consist of is get you a bowl and put your dry ingredients in that. So for today's cookies that we're going to be making, it's a gingerbread cookie dough. So in that bowl of dry ingredients, that's just my flour, my soda, and then all of my spices. Typical gingerbread cookie dough, you know, you're going to have ginger, obviously, cinnamon, cloves, nutmeg, a little bit of salt, and yeah, then just your flour and your baking soda. So kind of just whisk those together and have those ready to incorporate into your wet ingredients. Your wet ingredients is as simple as just dumping them into your stand mixer with the paddle attachment and creaming those ingredients together. So your butter, your sugar, egg, and then of course your molasses. After you get all of that incorporated, then you just slowly start adding in those dry ingredients that you whisk together, and voila, you have cookie dough. So it's just as easy as that. I take a couple of sheets of just a cling wrap, and then I divide that dough in half, and I put them in the pieces of the cling wrap, kind of form them into disc shapes, and then that is what we have here today, is the cookie dough that is ready to go. In terms of rolling out your dough, you have a couple of different options. Definitely, before you start the actual process of making your cookies, it's my recommendation. Sanitize your workspace that you're going to be working in. Have a clean dishwasher, clean sink, you know, nothing that's too cluttered. And just have everything as streamlined and organized as you can. That makes for a happier, kind of less chaotic cooking environment, okay? Also a clean trash can, because you want to be able to just throw stuff in there as you need to. So you have a couple of different options in terms of rolling out your cookies. You can either flour your surface, put your discs down. Keep in mind they're going to be hard where they've been in the refrigerator. So you're going to have to use some elbow grease, honey, okay? And if you're going to use the floured surface, definitely put some flour on your rolling pin as well, because as you work the dough, it will become a little bit tacky and it's going to want to stick to your rolling pin. So definitely flour your surface, flour your rolling pin, and you can definitely roll them out that way. Another way is simply to lay down a piece of parchment, put down your disc of cookie dough, put down a second piece of parchment, and you can roll out your cookie dough that way. All right, guys, so as you can see here, I do have my two discs of cookie dough. I have twigged my hair up. I have found that most folks prefer their food to be hair-free. So I do always, whenever I'm preparing food for someone else, I do try to like pull my hair up. So for today, I am gonna do my favorite method of rolling my dough, and that is just to do it on a floured surface. This is why it's imperative to kind of have your area disinfected. How many of you also put your like flour and stuff in bags inside your canisters? You can never be too cautious, right? So just put out a copious amount of flour. One thing about gingerbread dough, where it is dark, it can show on the back side of your cookies. So I'll show you how I handle that as well. Okay, so I just kind of get him ready. See how it kind of sticks to it? You can brush that off with a pastry brush. Okay, we just want to make sure it's not going to be sticking to our rolling pin and to our counter. So, like I said a while ago, you definitely want to flour your rolling pin as well, and then get to rolling. So, let's talk about thickness of your cookies, okay? What I have noticed is I like a pretty sturdy cookie, okay? So, I definitely go a little thick. I just kind of start filling my dough. If I feel it's like thicker in one area, I will roll that area. Okay, so that's about right. So that chimney wants to break off. Just punch out your cookies. And then what you have to do over and over again is re-roll out your dough, okay? Be very careful. Something else I do, let me get my spatula. My counter definitely needs floured down again. If you're having trouble getting your cookie off your counter, just use a spatula. Okay. brushing off that excess flour. And just take your dough. And you're gonna re-roll it, okay? So after you punch out your cookies, you're gonna do this many, many times. Reflour your surface, okay? Then just roll your dough back out. And remember, we've got this second disc that we will do as well. All right, so I have my first pan full of cookies ready to go in the oven. So as you can see, this big pan, I've got 15 cookies on here right now. I'll pop these in the oven at 350. These are kind of a small cookie. This cookie cutter is not all that big, you know, compared to some of the cookies that I've made in the past. So I'm gonna start checking these around 10 or 11 minutes, at the most 14 minutes. And yeah, we'll just see how we're going. But this is what they look like. I have a little bit more dough to go. My goal was to make about a dozen, so I'll probably have about 20 cookies. So works out really well. Another thing I want to recommend, definitely make extra than what you're aiming to make, because you're going to have a few that you either break or you make a big mistake on with your oil icing, and one that's not, you know, like able to be fixed. So there's always a few that I end up just eating, you know, if I mess up on. So definitely make a few that, you know, can be mistake pieces. And preparing for your royal icing. So if you don't know, in the cookie decorating world, royal icing is typically the icing that you use to decorate your cookies because it hardens down. Once it dries down and it's hard, like you can put, my buzzer just went off and I had to go and check my cookies. But once it hardens down and dries, you can put like all of your cookies in a big container and they're not going to get like messed up or anything. That icing is there to stay. So you use a meringue powder. That is basically the foundation of a royal icing. And I use piping bags to decorate my cookies. I have all my little components here for a decorating bag. So if you've never done this before, the bag is sealed here at the end, and what you want to do is, this is called a coupler, and it's actually two pieces, okay? So you're going to unscrew the ring, and you're going to have this open piece and the ring. This is what's going to connect the decorating tip to your bag. So just drop your coupler down in this long piece. So once you get your connector down into the tip, okay, you see this top, this little line right here, okay? That is where you're going to want to cut your bag. So just take a marker, okay, and mark your bag. Right there is where you're going to cut. Let me pull my cookies out of the oven. These cookies smell amazing. To where we were. So this is the coupler. We put the little line where we're going to cut our bag. Pop that back out. So here's our mark, okay? Right there. Just take some scissors. You're going to cut your bag right there at that line, okay? Now you're going to drop your coupler back down in, and it is going to stick out down into that tip, okay? So right there at the line, that is right there. Now, in terms of decorating tips, as far as just filling the cookies, a good basic tip is a Wilton, either 3 or 4. And the numbers just mean how big the tip is, okay? So if you can see, all right, can you see that hole? Not really. There you go. This is a 1, this is a 3. The 3 is just a little bigger. So I'm actually gonna go for a 4. And here's a 4. Cause that's what I'm gonna kinda flood my cookies. And by flood, I mean cover the whole thing, just generally, okay? So you put that on top of your end right there. And then you take that ring And when you screw it up on that coupler, voila. That is, my friends, how you have a decorating bag ready to go. You'll see this again later on because I've not actually even made my royal icing yet. But I just fold my bag over. I kind of take the tip and I fold it up because I don't want like icing oozing out of that. So I put it in a glass. You know, and this just helps if you're like me and you're doing this on your own, you don't have an extra set of hands, because sometimes you need an extra set of hands to do this. I just put it over my glass like that, with that tip facing up. And then I fill this with whatever color icing I'm going to be using. And again, I will show you this later, but that's kind of how I have all of my different colors in their bag. Next thing, I guess, is in terms of making your royal icing, one thing you're going to want to consider investing in is gel food coloring. And see, like for these cookies that I'm making today, I'm doing one design. Out of that design, I have 5 different colors of icing that I'm going to be using. Typically, like say when I make my Christmas cookies, I'll make, you know, 3, 4, 5 dozen, and I'll use 10 different cookie cutters. So I'm making Santa bellies and Christmas trees and stockings and candy canes, and I need every color under the rainbow for those cookies. I need black and red and white and, you know, all the colors. So I recommend buying this. This is by Wilton. This is a 12 color. You get all of these colors in this box. Little sample pack of gel food coloring. So why you want to use gel food coloring as opposed to liquid? Biggest reason, you get better color payoff. It's more vibrant with a gel food coloring. The other reason is because the liquid food colors can affect the consistency of your icing. So where these are not liquid, it doesn't affect the consistency at all. Still got 3 minutes, but if you can see this royal icing, it is definitely very thick. Okay, we want to flood our cookies. We need it to be a little bit more liquidy, so I'm going to add more water. Just get my little handy dandy cup of water here again. Okay. And you know, things that are going to affect this, the humidity outside, you know, the humidity where you live, that's going to play a role.
And two, you know, you just need to, you're going to have to learn royal icing, and you'll be able to kind of eyeball it. This is kind of an important part, so. I will say this, you can always water this down after it's out of the mixer, but it's harder to thicken it back up. So definitely it's better to play with too thick of icing than too thin. All right, so we have been whipping for 10 minutes, and as you can see, there's no way you can flood a cookie with this consistency, but I'll show you what we do. All right, you can see my little setup I've got going here. Okay, this is for all my colors. I'll get into that in just a second. But what you want to remember with royal icing, when you leave royal icing open to air, what does it do? It hardens, okay, and it dries. So get all your icing, and I always transfer mine into a bowl that has a lid. I love these Pampered Chef mixing bowls that have the lids. I'll show you. Look how beautiful and shiny. Oh, I love royal icing. Okay. So, when you're thinking about your colors and what you're going to be doing on your cookies, some colors you want to be a little bit thinner. Some you're going to want to be thicker, okay? You can do a border. You always want to do borders with a thicker icing, and then you want to flood with a thinner, okay? Basically, the vision I have for these gingerbread houses, I want to do a pink house. Little pink houses. How many of y'all are Mellencamp fans? I want to do a pink house, and so my pink frosting is going to be much thinner. That way, I can cover the whole cookie, okay? So, let me pick you up here. I am in between doing my colors and while I'm working on my piping and things of that nature, okay? I keep this covered with my cover, okay? But as you can see, I have five colors I'm going to use in this cookie. I have pink, brown, white. There's no white food coloring because our frosting is, in fact, already white. A bluish teal, and then a burgundy, okay? So, I know I want my pink frosting icing to be a little thinner. So, I'm going to mix me just a little bit in this bowl. And that's what I do. I keep my basic bowl of royal icing covered. And then I just dip out, and I make it to the consistency for whatever color it is that I'm using. So just dip out some of this. And again, this is very, very thick. We're going to thin this down. Don't worry. Okay. It's going to be the basic color that I use. So I'm going to make quite a bit of pink. I don't even know if that's enough. Let's do a little bit more. Okay. All right. Covering him back up. I'm going to get me a spoon. So now, go back in with your water and just add a little, okay? And then I just hold my bowl. And you'll get to where you can kind of tell, is this going to flood my cookie? This is more like a border consistency, okay? That looks like it might be about right. Okay. And see how it's just getting a little bit more spreadable, not so thick. All right, let's add us some pink food color in here. Okay. I think that's pretty good. So then this is where I take my bag, okay? And I'm just going to put some pink in there. again, cover it with the lid. Now you take your little baggie of icing. We're gonna seal it, okay? So just take your bag up like that. And then you take one of these little rubber bands and wrap it around your bag, okay? And pull the little tab through. Okay. All right, and I'll show you up close what that looks like. So it just holds your frosting in there, okay? When you are frosting your cookie, anchor your arm. You know, put it down, don't be like up here like moving around freely. Anchor your arm, and then a scribe tool is like this little needle thing that you can get. I have one. I'm a creature of habit and I prefer to use toothpicks. So I'll show you where these come in to play here in just a minute. You can really work with royal icing. So really just get it on here and I'll show you, okay? You can go kind of sloppy. Okay, you will get better at this, I promise. Okay, so you got your basic outline. Fill that in with frosting, baby. Just go for it. You can go around in a circle. Okay, now. That's why I always keep my glass over here. Take your scribe or your toothpick and you're just gonna work that frosting. So say like you wanted to go down here in this corner more, work it, okay? If, let's say you let it run off the side, you can scrape it off. It's very easy to work with. Don't be afraid of royal icing. It's like every decorator's dream. See? So say I want to run this over a little bit. Just work it. Does that make sense? Okay. Work it. I need a glass of water. Fill in all your little holes. It will dry smooth and beautiful. There's some food coloring we didn't really mix in too well, so we're going to mix that in. Okay. All right. You can perfect this all you want. All right, so now that you have your basic icing, what you wanna do is take your cookie and kinda shake it. This perfects that icing, okay? Another thing you can do, drop it like that, okay? That pink I kinda messed up because there was food coloring in it. Once you get a cookie flooded, just set it over on your drying rack to harden, okay? So then after I use my scribe or my toothpick, I just keep a paper towel or a rag and I can wipe it off. This will go pretty daggone fast. All right, guys, so we have our first like flooding on our cookies. Let me get this cookie. Let you see what they look like. That is about perfect. I can't wait to see how these turn out. So I have since washed my coupler and my decorating tip because that is all of the cookies that I have made. I do have some pink frosting icing left over, and I have had a neighbor asked me if I would make some cookies for her family. So I haven't promised yet because I don't know that I'll have time this week, but I'm going to go ahead and pop this in the refrigerator. Any frosting that you're not going to use in the foreseeable future, you can store that in the refrigerator. Again, you want to make sure that it's covered. And yeah, so I really want this pink layer to have some time to dry because I'm going to be piping on like windows and, you know, little decorations here and there, a roof line, and I really want those things to be, to stand out from the pink background. So this is pretty wet. This is like the first one that I did. It needs, you know, quite a bit of time to solidify. So what I'll probably do is take a break from decorating the rest of the night. Let this set up and get hard, and then tomorrow we will pick back up where we left off. Alright guys, so I just took this out of the refrigerator. This was my blue frosting that we used yesterday. This is kind of my guinea pig cookie that I've been working with. But as you can see, I had a fatter tip on it yesterday. I want a really little tip for some detail work, so I'm just going to take that off. And we'll see if I have a one clean. Got a one that is clean, and I'm just going to pop some details on my door just to see how I can do. So that's why I try to keep my, and all I did was just fold it up like that, pop it back down in the glass, and that's where it sat in the refrigerator overnight.